get your hair cut. First when I was white. See you later, I'm going to set your stage.
And even when you saw this, you did not change your minds and follow him.
Master!
which the tax is paid. Well, whose head is on here? Whose inscription?
Caesar's.
Then pay Caesar what is due Caesar. But pay God what is due God.
Master, what is the greatest commandment of them all?
Thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul. That is the greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. All the rest of the law, and all that the prophets have written, is based on these first two. The Pharisees and the doctors of the law sit in the chair of Moses. Therefore, listen to what they say. Pay attention to their words, but do not follow their practices. For they say one thing and do another. They make up heavy packs and pile them on men's shoulders, and they don't raise a finger to lift the load themselves. Everything they do is done for show. Oh, they go about with broad phylacteries, with large tassels on their robes. They like to have their places of honor at the feasts and at the synagogues, and to be greeted respectfully in the streets, and to be called teacher. But you must not be called teacher, for you have one teacher, the Messiah. And you must call no man on earth father, for you have only one father, and you are all brothers. Alas for you, lawyers and Pharisees, hypocrites that you be. Searching for souls and searching them, you travel the land, you scour the sea. Then when you've got your converts, you make them twice as fit for hell as you are yourselves. Alas, alas for you, lawyers and Pharisees, hypocrites that you are. Searching the kingdom of heaven awaits you, you will not venture half so far. Other men who might enter the gates you keep from passing through, drag them down with you. You snakes, you vipers brood, you cannot escape being devil's food. I send you prophets and I send you preachers, sages and rages and ages of teachers. Nothing can lower your mood. Alas, alas for you, lawyers and Pharisees, hypocrites to a man. Fathers began. You don't have time to scorn and to scoff. It's getting very late. Vengeance doesn't wait. You snakes, you vipers brood. You cannot escape being devil's food. I send you prophets and I send you preachers. Sages and rages and ages and teachers. Nothing can bar your mood. Blind eyes, blind. Many will come claiming my name, saying I am the Messiah, and many will be misled by them. For the time is coming where you will hear the noise of battle near at hand. For nation will make war upon nation, and kingdom upon kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in many places. But with all this, the birth pangs of a new age begins. For as things were in Noah's days,
happy Noah's days.
So will they be when the Son of Man comes.
Come on, animals, come on. There's a 73% chance of rain.
In the days before the flood, men ate and drank and married, and they knew nothing until the flood came and washed them all away. Have you no faith? Peace. Be still. For when the Son of Man comes, there will be men working in the fields. And of these men working, one will be taken, and the others left. Women, grinding at the wheel. And of these women grinding, one will be taken, and the others left. So keep awake then, for you do not know on which day your Lord is to come. Remember, if the householder had known what time the burglar was coming, he would have stayed awake all night. So keep awake then, for the Son of Man will come at a time when you least expect. Now, who is the trusty servant? A man charged by his master to take care of his servants and pay them at the proper time. Well, happy is the man who is at the job when his master returns, for he will be left in charge of all of his property. But what of the bad servant, who sits around saying, oh well, the master was a long time coming, and begins bullying the other servants, and eating and drinking with his drunken friends. I tell you this, his master will come at a time he least expects, on a day he does not know, and he will cut him to pieces. And then he will take his place among the hypocrites, where there is wailing and gnashing of teeth. Remember, in the kingdom of heaven.
Master, this woman was caught in the very act of adultery. And in the law that Moses has laid out, such women as her are to be stoned.
Oh yeah? What do you say about it, mister?
The one of you who is faultless shall throw the first stone. No one condemned you?
No one, sir.
Nor do I condemn you. You may go. Do not sin again.
called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priest and said, "What will you give me to betray him to you?" They gave him 30 pieces of silver. And from that moment on, he began to look for any opportunity to betray him.
By my side.
That
Tell you this, of you among us will betray me. Yours. Do quickly what you have to. Take this and eat. Eat, for this is my body. Take this and drink. Drink, for this is my blood. The blood of the covenant poured for the forgiveness of sins. And I tell you, I shall never again drink from the fruit of the vine until I drink it with you all in the kingdom of my Father.
Oh.
ready to break with grief. Stop here and stay awake with me. Yet not as I will, but as thou wilt. What? Could none of you stay awake with me? Stay awake 1 hour and be spared the test? Oh, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And everyone else may fall away on your account, but I never will.
I tell you this. Tonight, before the cock crows, you will all betray me 3 times. Father, if it be not possible for this cup to pass me by without my drinking from it, thy will be done!
If you truly are the Son of God, turn those stones into bread.
Man does not live by bread alone. He lives on every word that God utters.
If you're the Son of God, throw yourself down. For as the scripture says, he will send angels to hold and support you in their arms.
You shall not tempt the Lord your God.
All these things I will give you. If you will do me, I'm it!
Be gone, Satan! You shall do homage to the Lord your God and worship him alone. You have to do. Put down the sword! He who lives by the sword dies by the sword. Do you not suppose that I can appeal to my father, who at once sent me 12 legions of angels to come to my aid? Do you take me for a bandit that you come after me with swords and cudgels? Day after day I sat teaching in the synagogues, and you did not come for me then. But all of this has happened to fulfill what the prophets have written.
anniversary celebration in the lobby. Hope to see you there.
Party in the lobby!